In the early modern world, there were three Islamic empires: the Ottoman Empire, the Safavid Empire in Persia, and the Mughal Empire in India. In this micro lecture, we will talk about the largest, wealthiest, and most populous of these three, the Mughal Empire. The Mughal Empire reached an extension of over 1.2 million square miles at the end of the 17th century. Some authors argue that the empire had between 100 and 150 million people, and in that sense, the only political entity comparable was the Ming Dynasty in China. The empire's origins can be traced back to the early 16th century when a Turkish leader named Babur captured Kabul and established a kingdom in Afghanistan. Babur was a bold traveler and adventurer who often claimed that he was a descendant of Genghis Khan and Timur, two of the greatest conquerors of the Eurasian steppe. In 1526, commanding an army of 12,000 men equipped with firearms, Babur defeated the Sultan of Delhi at the First Battle of Panipat. Subsequently, Babur captured the cities of Agra and Delhi, which paved the way for his conquering of northern India. After the battle, many of his men wanted to return to Afghanistan, but Babur decided to stay in India. We know many things about Babur because he liked to write. His autobiography is one of the most important texts of the early modern period. In his writings, Babur talked about his military campaigns, the places and people he knew along the way, food, swimming, and many other things. During the reign of Babur's son, Humayun, the Mughals suffered some defeats and lost their territories in Afghanistan. However, Babur's grandson, Akbar, was able to reorganize the empire, making it the greatest in Indian history. Only 13, when he took power, Akbar pursued expansionist policies, reorganized the state, and was able to dominate most of the Indian subcontinent. He built a centralized political system under the sole authority of the Mughal Emperor. Among other things, Akbar made Persian the official language of the empire, developed an administrative bureaucracy, built infrastructure, and created a uniform system of taxes. Akbar's descendants extend the Mughal Empire to the southern part of the subcontinent. However, despite all their power, these rulers of the Mughal Empire had internal conflicts and struggled for power. On more than one occasion, debates over succession led them to fight amongst each other. In 1739, Persian adventurer Nadir Shah invaded India, defeated the Mughal army, and looted Delhi. After his terrible defeat, the Mughals lost most of their power in India, although the official end of the dynasty only happened in 1857. This is all we have for today. If you have any questions, please let us know on Moodle or Slack. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.